Ladies and gentlemen, the Jimi Hendrix Experience.
I mean, Jimi Hendrix is where my obsession with the Anthem starts, and I think Jimi Hendrix himself was obsessed with the Anthem. I mean, we think of Woodstock as like this incredible improvisatory moment where he just sort of picks up the Anthem and riffs on it. But in fact, he had been playing it for over a year before, and he played it for a year after, so over 70 times. Woodstock, in many ways, is just the midpoint, but in many ways, an artistic high point. And it's really because he puts protest and patriotism together. It was criticized at the time, anyway, as being a kind of burning of the American flag, you know, musically. But it's not. It's really a celebration of the nation and of possibility. He's at Woodstock. It's been overrun by fans, but it's sort of the new generation of Americans sort of saying there's hope for the future. We can remake the country in sort of the images of sharing, of Woodstock, of sort of this communal celebration of what it means to be American and to support one another. And Woodstock seemed, I think, to be a moment of possibility, a moment of optimism and opportunity for someone like Hendrix. And when he played the Anthem, it was almost like he was a kind of camera. I mean, he was looking out into the country. He was sort of taking a photograph, if you will, of the political tensions of the moment. And so in his Woodstock Anthem, you have both the tension of Vietnam, you have, you know, the quotation of Taps, right, sort of honoring his own friends in the 101st Airborne because he was a member of the paratroopers, but also, you know, references to gunfights, rioting in the streets after Martin Luther King's killing. And then you also have this really powerful, strong, in-tune, in-time version of the Anthem that frames those sort of call-outs, you know, the illustrations of the bombs bursting in air, the rocket's red glare. It shows the complexity of what an artist can bring to the Anthem to make their own statement while making a collective statement, you know, reflecting on the nation as a whole. So it's just a perfect artistic statement for me. When people are offended by a performance that seems to say something else, something extra that adds protest to the Anthem, there are sometimes calls like, well, we need to have a law that says there's only one right way to do the Anthem so that nobody desecrates our country. For me, the power of musicians to put their own ideas, their own feelings behind the Anthem is really the magic, it's really the power of the Anthem. If we were to have a law that said you have to do it this way, it would actually make patriotism impossible, because patriotism is the expression of a sincere love of the nation, a sort of hope for the nation, a devotion to the country. If you have a law that says you have to do it this way, then doing it that way or performing it at all just means it signals obedience, right? I'm following the law, I'm doing what I'm told. This is not a country that's founded on doing what you're told, right? This is a country founded on making your independence ring forth. The price of sincere patriotism is the potential for protest. You have to make protest possible to make patriotism possible.